Let us now analyze the condition of formation of a real image of a real object by a convex lens. To understand the same, let us consider a situation when we are given with a convex lens and this is principal axis on which F and 2F points are marked. Here we know if the focal length of the lens is F and if an object is placed exactly at the 2F position on one side of the lens, its image will be produced on the other side exactly at 2F position. And in this situation, for the real object, as the real image is produced, if we just see the separation between object and image, here you can see the separation is equals to 4 times the focal length, as there is a separation between 2F points on the both sides. Now let's do one thing. We displace this object toward left by distance x. If it is displaced toward left by distance x, that is toward infinity, we know well that image will displace also toward left, say by distance y. But as object reaches infinity, image reaches the focal point. So if it is x, here we can directly write the magnitude of y will be less than x, as its displacement from 2f point to infinity will be mapped from 2f point to f on the other side for the position of image. So for this new position of object O1 and this new position of image I1, if we just see the separation between these two, here we can see object is displaced by x and image is displaced by y, which is less than x. So this distance d will be more than 4f. So if object is shifted away from lens, the separation between real object and real image will be greater than 4f. Now let's do another phenomena over here. Let's understand the phenomena by displacing the object toward the right side. Say if it is displaced to the right side by a distance x1 from its initial position, then obviously the image will be displaced also toward right side by a distance y1, but in this situation the value of y1 will be greater than x1 because the object positions between 2f to f on one side will be mapped on the other side for image positions from 2f to infinity. That's why here directly we can see on displacing object by x, image will be displaced by more than x. Or if it is x1, it will be more than x1. Then in the final situation, if the object position is O2 and the image position is I2, if we find out the separation between object and image positions, this D1 will again be greater than 4f because image will be displaced by more distance compared to the distance by which object is displaced. So here we can see for a real object and a real image, anywhere on the principal axis, the separation between them will always be greater than or equal to the 4 times of focal length of the lens. So here we can see, we can write down a note to understand the same. If for an object, using a convex lens, we produce an image on a screen, then for this, always the separation between object and screen must be greater than or equal to 4 times the focal length of lens. As if we are finding the condition of formation of a real image of real object by a convex lens, then the general condition for a real image of real object is object must be placed beyond the focal point of the lens, because we already studied that if object is placed between focal point and optic center of lens, then image will be virtual. So object must be placed beyond the focal point, and in that situation, always the separation between object and image, or if image is obtained on a screen, then always the separation between object and a screen must be greater than or equal to 4 times the focal length of lens. This you must always keep in mind.